How do you sort Google form responses into separate tabs in a Google Sheet? That's what we're going to work on today. So in this video, I have a Google form that is the responses are going to this spreadsheet. So here's my form. I'm asking for the last name, first name. The students will choose their class period that they belong to, and then their answer to their question. So here are the responses that I have received, but what I would like it to do is I would like for the answers, I would like to be able to check it by my class periods. So I want a separate tab for first period, third, second, third, fourth, and fifth. That's what I'd like to do. So that's what we're going to work on today. Now, before we go on, I do want to say there is a wonderful extension that is called the Two Tabs extension by Alice Keeler. That is wonderful. But the one thing that about that is not dynamic without you having to reset it. So you could try that out if you already have all your forms ready and you don't have anyone else filling out the form. But for me, as a technology teacher, I want to be able to get the answers immediately sorted into the right tab without having to reset everything. So that's what this is about. So I'm going to go ahead and open up a new tab in my sheet. And then now I'm going to put right here, I'm going to do my headers. So for me, I'm going to just bring the headers that I want over. I just want last name, first name, and the question. So how I already have these highlighted, I will just choose my control key and hold that down and then press B1, C1, and then E1. And then I'm going to hold Control C or Command C if you're on a Mac. And that's copied those. And then I'm just going to paste those right over here with Control V. So now I have this set up. So what we're going to do is we're going to put in a query function. So to start any formula in a Google spreadsheet, you need an equal sign. And then we're going to use the query function. So spell query correctly. And then I can press Tab when it pops up here. And it will already give me an open parentheses. If you click this right here, it kind of walks you through a great example. So what we want to do is we want to go back to the responses so we can get our data, and I'm going to highlight this whole area. So I want it though to be responses, that's the name of my tab, and then A2 through the end of E. So I'm going to take off this 9 here because I just want it to go all the way to the bottom. And then I'm going to do a comma, and then I'm going to do our query always starts with a quotation mark. So it's going to be select. Now, if you wanted to bring in everything and not just select columns, you would just do an asterisk where that means select all. But I want to only select the columns that I want. I just want column B, C, and E. So I'm going to type B, comma, C, comma, and E, where D, the class period, equals my class period. So I want it to be first period. So I'm going to use a single quote and I have to type it exactly. First period, single quote. And now I close the quotation mark and then close the parentheses, and then I can press enter. And you can see that all of those for first period have come through. So that is the way you can do that. And you can make a tab for every single page. However, there's an easier way or a faster way to set this up. It takes time to set it up, but once you set it up, it's a whole lot easier than having to copy and paste everything over and over. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to delete all of this information here. So I'm going to actually just delete the formula. Okay. What I want is I'm going to go ahead and use one of Alice Keeler's other tab tools extensions, and I'm going to use the template tab by Alice Keeler. If you don't have any of these add-ons, you just go to add-ons and get add-ons, and you can search for that and make sure you install that into your browser. She is wonderful. If you don't know anything about Alice Keeler, I highly recommend. She is amazing with all things technology, Google related especially. All right, so we're going to go to add-ons and template tab by Alice Keeler, and I'm going to set up the sheet. And in this sheet, she has, will add the roster page. And then she also wants you to put your template on page 2. Now my template on my page 2 is the responses. So I'm going to go ahead and type in here. Oops, let's rewind. I'm going to go back here and just change this back to responses. And I'm going to move sheet 3 over to sheet 2. Because the most important thing you have to remember about this is she's going to run an app script is basically what this is, and it's going to take whatever is in sheet 2 position, and it's going to make that your template, and then she's going to make a copy of that, and it's going to make it a copy for every single thing we put on the roster. So this is the template. So I'm just going to go ahead and rename this template. Okay. So for the first, for here, you just need to type your class periods. And if I had a, this, if I had this copied, I don't know if I can copy that. If I had this already somewhere else already copied, I would take exactly what this is because it has to be exact as what is in your Google form. So I'm just going to type in first period. And it's very important that you spell it correctly. And then second period. I don't know why I'm misspelling it each time. Fourth period and fifth period. There we go. So that is what we want. Make sure it's exactly the same as what is on here. Okay, so now we're going to go to page two, which is what I have here, and this is where I want my answers to come in. So what I want to do is I'm going to put a drop down right here so I can select what class period it is, and I don't have to keep retyping that. So I'm going to go to my drop down, and I can either type it in again, or I'm just going to go drop down from a range. So I'm going to click over here and click this box. Type, click right in there and go back here, and I'm going to highlight right here and press OK. And that way now, when I go back to template, this is going to show those in there. Now, I don't like the chip view for a couple of reasons, but I just go right back into advanced options and choose arrow and then press done. And then now we just have the arrow. So that's what I want there, so I can just like put first period. And then I also want to go ahead and put my query formula here. So I'm going to do that again. So equals, and also this is the time before you do all of this, let's bring this, freeze that first row. If you want to make this here, take off my formula though, because I'm already typing. I want to take this here. If you want to format and do whatever you want with your format and get it the way you like it, now is the time to do that, to make it look nice. So take care of this how you want. If you don't want all of these columns, I would come through here and delete the extra columns that you don't want. Spread everything out exactly how you want it. So this is the time to do that. And if you want an extra thing for notes, go ahead and have that right here. Okay, so now we're putting in that formula. Again, it's equals query. And once you have that query in there, you're going to go back to now responses, and you're going to take this whole page. But remember, we are going to put that and then select, and then you're going to do B, C, E, where D equals. And now we're going to say, hey, we want it to go back to right here. We want it to go back to A1 on this page. But the thing is, for a drop down, you have to do a few things. You have to surround it by three quotation marks and an ampersand. And then now you can click on this where the drop down is, and you're going to have to do it again. Ampersand, three quotation marks. Okay, that's what you're going to have to do for a drop down. Also, before we do anything else, let's go ahead and lock this. So you can lock it by choosing F4, like click inside of that and click F4, and it will just put those dollar signs there and it will lock that range. That's also important because sometimes we can have things not work and it's just because the range was not locked. Okay, so now when you do that, you see that first period is filled out there. So I don't think I had anything for second period. So it says NA, right? And then third period, fourth period, fifth period, okay? And you might just be content with it like this, and that is all you need. But one thing we can do, if it's NA, let's type something else. So do you see how second period has nothing? So it says NA. If you don't want the NA to go there, all you have to do is right after the equal sign, we're going to put if NA, another open parentheses, come all the way to the end, comma, and then close parentheses, and then enter, and now it's gone. Okay, but if you want to do something where you have, like for me, I know I want to be able to count how many of my students have turned it in without having to like scroll down, we can put another formula right here where it can count everything for us. So what we're going to do is we're going to click equals. Okay. And then we're going to put the word number of responses, which we want as a text. So I'm just going to put in quotation marks, number of responses. and then quotation, I mean, not a colon, and then a space, and then we have equals, okay? So it's gonna say number of responses, and then I want it to count how many people have responded. So we're gonna do an ampersand, and then now here's our formula, count A, okay? So it's gonna count the number of values in this range, and then open parentheses, and we're gonna go A3 to A. And again, I'm also going to lock that, okay? I just chose F4 or go back and put a dollar sign there. And then I'm going to close my parentheses and then press enter. And then you can see how many people have responded, all right? So now once you have this in here and you have this set up the way you want, now it's time to run that extension. So we're gonna go back to extensions and we're gonna go to the template tab by Alice Keeler and we're gonna run it. So what's going to happen now is this will actually make a tab for every single class period. And it's so nice. This can do a lot of tabs and it saves you so much time. So now you can see these tabs are made. You can also see that the roster and the template tabs, they're still there. They're just hidden. That's part of her script. And I'm going to move my responses page back to the front if I want to look at it. But now I just go back in here and I set it up where it's going to show each class period and move that to third, move this to fourth, and move this to fifth. And again, if you don't want one for everyone, you're fine. If you just click on this one and you can just see each class as they come in. But this is how you do it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe, like, ask for notifications. And if you have anything you'd like to learn more about Google Sheets, or if you have a tip for me, please leave it in the comments. I'd love to know.